Copper, quick question.
Okay.
In the year 2040, this country that we live in will be in debt up to our ears with a backlog of deficient roads. Can you tell us and the listeners how much money we are going to be in debt?
We got trillions and zillions, but
we are definitely going to be, pick a number.
I want to say nine. Three?
$3 trillion in debt is where we're headed in 2040 if we don't get a handle and start preserving our infrastructure in America.
This is Blair Barnhart, driving America for better roads, and I snuck out here on Gresham Road in City of Marietta. Kudos, shout out to City of Marietta for doing this excellent in-place asphalt recycling project here in Georgia. And I caught up here with the crew after they shut down on a Friday afternoon, and the equipment is static. You know, I've been around this in-place asphalt recycling stuff since the mid-90s, and you know what? My blood still gets hot and excited when I see the equipment. So having been around this stuff pretty much for the last two decades, you can imagine how excited it is for me to see a road like this being transformed from an old road into a new road. So anyways, purpose of today's session, this stop in Marietta, Georgia, is to get everybody up to speed on the next couple of months of training opportunities. So if you've ever wondered, you know, I want to be a pavement manager, Blair, or I've done this all my life, but I'm really not sure about the in-place asphalt recycling or the pavement preservation, or, you know, what do you use for straight edges, Blair? Where do you get them from? Blair, I know you do distance measuring in the field, and that old estimator and you comes out and you reconfirm all the measurements for us for our bid documents. What instrument do you use? Well, I get these on eBay, and I'm almost afraid to say it because I'll never be able to get any more once I tell everybody. But anyways, these are the Jamar Rack 100. This is the old school version. I don't use the new technology that they have, but this is a Rack 100. We've got a half a dozen of these units. They can run off the OBD2 plug, or you can hardwire them into the odometer. And that's a distance measuring unit, or DMI. Distance measuring instrument. The measuring wheels we've used in the field for years are the Keson model RR318N in feet. Now, if you're listening from Canada or one of the European countries outside of USA, it's probably going to be a metric wheel that you want to get. So just double check on the model number. But that bright orange seems to work for us, so we don't back over them. And you know, the micropaver guides, we wear them out, whether we're doing street saver or micropaver, we're generally going to pick up on the 20 different pavement stresses. So if you're wondering why I'm mentioning all this, it's because during the classroom sessions, whether they're 1 day, 3 hours, 2 days, whether it's the 50 or 60 hours of online curriculum for IPMA Academy, you're going to get all this information available to you. What, Blair, what do you use for drills? For, I know you go out and you actually do network level coring. What do you use? We use the DD130 with the 3-inch. We've kind of settled in on the 3-inch diamond tip drill bit here. And the DD130 seem to work well for us. We've run them off of inverters. We've run them off of generators. And in any case, if you'd like more information on that, you can go ahead and email me, blair@ipma.co. And any questions that you have along the way, anything to do with pavement management. This is a great time in our life. We've got the MAC 21, the new transportation language involves pavement preservation, asset management, pavement management, in-place asphalt recycling, sustainability, all those key words. You know, I think I may be the first person ever to put the words pavement preservation, pavement management, and in-place asphalt recycling all in the same sentence. Nonetheless, let's go over our training opportunities that we have coming up here. October 18, 19, we have NWETC, Northwest Environmental Training Center, 2-day session here on pavement management in place asphalt recycling and pavement preservation. This will be in Seattle, Washington. We have the Northwest Pavement Management Association meeting coming up. Plenty of great training opportunities there. I'll be one of the speakers up there for that particular conference. And a lot of our expert pavement managers will be in attendance up there. So October 23rd, 26th, Vancouver, Washington is the date and the location for that. Then we've got APWA, Southern California chapter, November 1st. I've got a 3-hour training session that I'm gonna do at no charge, as far as I can tell, and you'll get PDH credit hours for attending that. And then there's a great afternoon session with vendors. Also, there will be a panel discussion later on with some very distinguished speakers that Lisa has lined up for that. So Vancouver, so we got Seattle, Vancouver, and then we're in Palm Springs, California, out in the desert. That's APWA, Southern California, November 1st. APWA Northern California chapter, November 7 and 8. I'll be doing a talk up there in Richmond, California. A lot of great things going on up there in public works. Some great sessions lined up. And then we have the open enrollment only for 2 weeks with the IPMA Academy. That's International Pavement Management Association Academy. Hope to see you sign up for that. Now, this is where you're going to get a wealth of information. 50 to 60 hours of online curriculum and university level courses here on pavement preservation, in place asphalt recycling, all things cold in place, hot in place, and full depth reclamation, soil stabilization, all those things that keep you awake at night wondering, Blair, what do you do when we've got this particular PCI rating and we've proved for all of them, we've got so many deep patches, and how would we best go out and do that most eco efficiently for the least amount of money and the longest service life. So IPMA Academy training online enrollment, IPMA.co is the website, and you're gonna wanna keep a close eye on that enrollment period, December 1 through 14. Classes will start January 1st, and it will take about 4 to 5 months to complete that, and then you'll apply to the IPMA Advisory Board that's headed up by Chair Imelda Diaz from LA County. Hope to see you at one of these locations. And in the interim, think great things with pavement preservation, in-place asphalt recycling, and your pavement management program. Great successes. The stories go on and on. And you know, I've said for many years that asphalt is the number one recycled product in America. And yet, very few people know that we only recycle 3% of our roads in place. And this is a travesty, and I would definitely like to encourage you to let everybody you know, as we drive America for better roads, let everybody you know that pavement management, in-place asphalt recycling, and pavement preservation are your key to better roads for less money and more eco-efficient along the way. So Blair Barnhart, we'll be signing off here from our location in Marietta, Georgia. Hope to see you at the next stop.
You know, I think you just said it all. I think you're exactly right. That's very good information. And I mean, right now we're in such a bad place. I can't even just begin to describe our debt as of now. So I can't imagine the year 2040.
Well, think of it this way, Copper. Here's an idea. Our grandchildren won't be able to afford to come down to Mountain Biscuits to buy a biscuit because they'll be paying for a backlog of deficient roads in America. If we don't learn how to preserve them, we have a D-minus infrastructure right now. Were you aware of that?
I was not aware of that. That's a bad thought. No biscuits? Man. Woo!
Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for
having
me.
And can you say with us right now, driving America.
Driving America.
For better roads.
For better roads.